Hi friends, my name is Ankur Gupta. I am currently a graduate student majoring in Telecommunication Systems Management from Northeastern University, Boston. As part of the SDN syllabus, I am supposed to present a project regarding one of the controllers or one of the functions of SDN. So the topic that I have taken up is multicasting in SDN. And I'm going to be implementing a simple multicasting feature using the SDN controller. So basically, I'll just go through what SDN can do to help in the multicasting department. So a controller with a global view can view the network and create topologies based on the global view. It knows all the possible replication points, and it can calculate the distribution trees based on this. So my project basically revolves around creating an application that will help in identifying the host creating a database and putting it into a particular group ID and giving metrics in order to give a specific functionality to that particular host. So for the project, I've used Ryu as the SDN controller. I've used CPQD as the OpenFlow software switch. It's based on OpenFlow 1.3 protocol. And the network simulator, I've used Mininet for creating the topology. And it's all based in Ubuntu OS. So for creating the mininet topology, I use the following command. So it creates a tree kind of topology. And this is how the topology is going to be. So I'm just basically going to divide it into two multicast groups. So host one is going to be the multicast source. And host 4 is also going to be the multicast source, but each of them will be handling two different groups. And as I've mentioned in the arrows, those are the two groups that will be formed. So I started with the switch configuration. I used CPQD switch for installing the software switch wherein I could configure and give all the metrics for the switch. And Ryu controller, I developed a multicast feature code using Python and ran it using Ryu controller. So basically what happens is, in order for a host to subscribe to a particular group, it has to ping that particular multicast source. So if host, if you see here, if host 7 wants to subscribe to host 1, which is the multicast source, it has to just ping the host 1. It has to know the IP address. When it pings, the switch will be able to identify the source and the destination, and based on this, switch will form a group table. It will form the metrics as well. We would pre-configure the metrics in order to control the rate as well. So when I you see here, when I ping, when I try to ping, H7 pings H1, that's when the message comes in at the controller that 7, host 7 has been subscribed to host 1. That means host 7 is under the multicast source 1. So when we look at the flow stats and the group stats in the flow table of the switch, you can see that this is the source and this is the meter ID that it belongs to, and this is the group ID it belongs to. So this is what is logged into the switch for that particular host. And this is the group description wherein it describes the group that it belongs to. and the destination that is set. So this is the meter configuration for sending out the packets. It just helps in controlling the number of packets that can be sent by the multicasting source. So this will help in actually controlling the data rate and controlling the traffic. And yeah, that's it. Any questions?
Okay. Have you tested this with any kind of data flow?
That's what. Actually, there's a PMU simulator available that can be installed in the switch. If I had some more time, I could have installed a PMU server on the multicasting source part and a PMU client application on the host part, and then I could have sent the packets, continuous packets. I could have captured all these packets and seen the metric values. There is a way to test it, but it requires a lot of configuration. Any more questions?
How did you configure the switch?
It's all there in the code actually. So basically you can either use the commands, so for the meter modification or even the group add, you can use the commands that are pretty standard. You have to just mention the port and the group ID in order to do that. Or you can do it in the code as well. You can just give it this particular metric values for that. Since it was only two or three switches, I just did it in the code itself.